Hi friends, in this video let's talk about union in the Power BI DAX. So union is same as SQL Server and SSIS. It clubs multiple tables data. When I say multiple tables, all the tables should have same column numbers. Let us say table 1 contains 3 columns. If you are planning to apply union between table 1 and table 2, then both the tables should contain the same number of columns and the same column names. It is straightforward as SQL Server as well as SSIS. So let me show you first of all what are all the tables which I am planning to use for my example. So if you see here in SQL Server, I have two tables. One is a select star from employee and the other one is select star from employee 2. If you see both the tables, so both are having couple of columns are common columns, still here common, but these three columns are not the same. Okay, so these are the two tables which I am planning to use for my example. So let me open Power BI to show you the example. As I told you, the columns should have the same, the tables should have the same columns. So if you see, I cannot directly apply union between these two tables. So I need to modify the first table, then only I can apply union between these two tables. So let me load these two tables first. I want to cover that scenario as well. That is the reason why I choose these two tables. So my server name is .sysql2012, database name is DB training. Here I am going to select the table names EMP, EMP2. Okay, let's click on load. So once the table, once the data is ready, so I need to modify or I need to do the manipulation on the first table data, then only I can apply union between these two tables. So let me go to the select this EMP. So let's click on edit queries. So there I am going to create a new table with this new column set of columns which are required. Okay, so what are all the columns which are not required for me? These three columns. Okay, let's remove these. Okay, so now let's save this. The name of the employee table is EMP or whatever the name you want. So you can save that as close and apply. Now if you see the column names in the EMP, now you will see what are all the columns which you have earlier. So this is the table, you have it now. This is EMP2. So both will have the same columns now. Now I can directly apply union between these two tables. Now let's come to the modeling. Let's click on new table. So here the table default, by default it will come with the name as table. I'm going to make it as final table or something like that. Final data, whatever the name I want. Final data equal to union of first table is EMP comma EMP. Let's close this, enter it. Yes, now if you observe the data in the final table, final data table, so there you can see the club between these two. See, you have a one is there in first record, first as well as second. It means that data is clubbed between these two tables. This is how we are going to apply union in the Power BI DAX. So once this union is ready, you can use this table for any visualizations in the report view. That's it. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions in the Power BI DAX, please write a mail to training2sql@gmail.com. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for more technology videos. Thank you.